Will you all please welcome Richard Lewellen?
Good morning. I'm so grateful that you're here. Oh my gosh. How do you feel? Hi, Pete. Some of my closest personal friends are here this morning, hoping it goes well. Well, I'll tell you what, I feel like there's not a whole lot to do with y'all today because you've kind of been warmed up since about Wednesday, haven't you? And you just, it's just all there. So we're just going to get it going a little bit. There's some things we get to do on Saturdays at the end of Harmony U that we might not get to do at any other time in our lives. All of our people who wish that they were a bass, like me. So we're going to try that out for a minute. But let's all stand. Let's get going. Thank you so much to Les for the fantastic start to the session. You know, it's one of those things you don't know exactly when it started happening, but it just became something you just can't do without, you know? I just love it. And I was wondering, like many of you, if it would be just really a great idea to mic Les so that you could hear what he was saying, and that could be maybe not awesome. You don't know what's going on over here, so I don't know what would happen. I'm kind of curious, though, aren't you? I don't know. So, all right, let's just let's start off. Let's get our bodies kind of aligned. So we got our feet shoulder width apart, knees are slightly bent. Let's have our butts kind of tucked under just like you perched on the edge of a stool or something like that. Good. Then it takes a little bit of the curve out of your lower back. What I like about Belmont in particular compared to Missouri Western is the slope of that floor isn't quite so dramatic as it was over there. I remember standing there feeling like, oh man, first thing is hard. So we've got this going on. All right, so let's get our palms out to the side like that. Cause minimal injury to your friends. That's good. Yeah, Rick has got no problem. You and Diane have got it worked out, right? She just swing right past. There's no issues. All right, and now you've got your palms kind of facing forward. Put your awareness kind of where your lower ribs are, right? Your rib cage down there. And feel what it feels like when you turn your palms flat to the ceiling. Feel that nice stretch there? Ricky-likey. Leave it there. As your arms come down, just allow your chest and ribs to remain elevated like that. That's really nice. And let your shoulders kind of relax down a little bit. And then let's do this last little bit that for me, no one would tell me while I was competing, but I sure realized afterwards that singing like this is not a great idea with your head slung forward like that, but I kind of did. And there's a picture of me doing that apparently in headquarters right there on the wall is me having my head way up, chins high, and yeah, like that was a great plan. So let's not. So let's go ahead and feel that little elongation in the back of the neck that allows your head to just be kind of right over the top of your spine. See, that's good. You take that crimp right out of that garden hose. It's a lot better like that. But let's just see what that feels like for a second. Go ahead and do it the wrong way like me. Stick your chin forward, maybe your head, you know, and feel what it feels like here. Use your own hand to touch your own neck. And see what that, and it feels a little bit kind of like a fist to me, right? It's really gripped. And then as you elongate that neck and feel like your head's over, you say, oh, that's a lot better. Things might go well. That's good. Okay, that's fantastic. So now let's just blow out our air. Breathe in for a count of four. One, two, three, four. And let's breathe out for 20. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Very good. Now try something if you like. Let's go, just gonna tap your chest. Bone, 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 no bone. Try it again. Bone, 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 no bone. See, I took my anatomy and physiology class at the community college on the summer. And so bone, 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 no bone. That's how I find that spot there, okay? So right there, that's kind of a good little interesting spot. Go ahead and press on it for a little bit gently and see if you can press back. Press on it, see if you can kind of go, hey, you know, a little hey, just kind of push back there. That's kind of good. So what I'd like you to do this time is it's always relaxed when you are breathing in. But then after you breathe in, see if you didn't go, hey, just kind of switch that on a little bit and have some awareness of that as you're exhaling, okay? So it's relaxed as you, well, we're going to flex it while we're pushing out the air, so that's fine. So that's going to be flexed. Blow out your air. And then let go of it to breathe in. Switch it on. Let's breathe out for 20. 1, 2, 3, 4. Is it still there? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Does it feel a little easier to get all the way to 20? Just go like that, because I'm very fragile up here. It's like, okay, good, thank you. Yes, thank you. All right, that one worked. Okay, the next one, okay. Thanks, buddy. So the next one is, so you can do that, and just if you like that, keep doing that. But some of us might like to try something different, where as you're breathing out, just feel like your hands are kind of moving through that big vat of peanut butter, or you got bungee cords wrapped around your wrists, and you're kind of feeling that resistance as you pull apart like this. But do it just real, real slow as you're breathing out. So you do it like that, and then when you get to the end, you just kind of relax and breathe in, and go like that again. So let's do two sets of the stuff. So let's blow out our air, and then as you relax as you breathe in, breathe out for 20, real slow movement. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Relax, breathe in, and start again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Very good. Just kind of relax. I got to tell you, I thought my brother Jimmy was going to levitate there. Jimmy DeBusman, he was just... And he was rising up off the ground. I believe it. Okay. All right. So the next thing, did that. That's all going very well. How about we do this? A nice kind of gentle mid-range sigh. Let's do that. Good. So go ahead and just kind of, let's maybe loosen these little chewing muscles here a little bit. Relax them. Maybe we can get our face a little bit looser. Some of us have a head start on that. You're doing very well. Some loose faces out there. It's good. Okay. And that's another nice sigh like that. Let your tongue come forward so it's not kind of bunched up out there. Just let it be out front here again. Good. And now this time as you sigh and you get down to the bottom, see if you can just kind of slow that air down a little bit and see if you can get one of these little sounds. It's going to be easy today, like this. And just, it's got to be real gentle, no force behind it. And so we call that a vocal fry or a scrasp. It's kind of, it's just weird, but let's do it, okay? Nice sigh, gentle. And then just kind of slow down the air and let that little rumble. As long as you're gentle, that's kind of fun. Good. So this next one, this might be the first time we get into the upper range at all. Let's start down there with that little scrasp and just do it like a siren. We're going to go up and then sigh back down, okay? Here we go. Start down there, a little rumble. Here we go. Come over the top. That sounds so cool. That's great. Let's just play a little game for just no reason at all. On the way up, imagine it's kind of going up the back of your neck and the back of your skull and coming over the top and then skiing down the front of your face on the way down. See what that feels like. Nice and gentle. Start down there. Here we go. Well, that was fun for me. That was cool. I like that. All right, let's start right around here on an O. Everyone, nice, gentle O. Ladies, pick whatever octave you want, but it should be a real comfortable note that you can hang out on for a bit. Right here on this note, if for the guys, here we go. O. Very nice. That's beautiful. Now I'd like you to take your arms here and bring them up like this, as if you have this imaginary rain barrel right in front of you. Do it without the rain barrel, and then we'll bring the rain barrel up. Here we go. O. O. That's beautiful. Now take your hands, kind of swirl that sound around in there, make it spin and sparkle. You hear that up there? It's so pretty. Very nice. Now it gets to the fun part. We had a rain barrel. Now we have a 50-foot deep well, and we're going to go ahead and let some of that sound get all the way to the bottom of the well gently now. Here we go. Oh. Oh, so all the way, feels all the way down there, yeah. Oh, just gently, quietly. Oh, beautiful. Oh, all right, great. So that's our well, oh. We're going to go from that, oh, and we're going to turn it into an oo slowly and try to keep as much of that beautiful oh space into the oo as we go, okay? Here we go, oh. Gently, let's do this. If you sing it just a little quieter, it's going to be easier for you, more comfy, and the people around you will be happier. So just, oh, nice, gentle, pretty sound. Here we go. Oh, beautiful. Slowly to the ooh. Beautiful. Many of us did this. And you felt that real hooty ooh coming through. That's a beautiful thing. Some of us did this, which is natural to do, which was ooh, and that ooh kind of went and started banging right on the hard palate there. You could hear it kind of ooh. So let's choose the other one. We're going to choose the hooty one as we go from the ooh to the ooh. Let's do that together. Here we go. Ooh. That's so beautiful. Beautiful, well done. And just kind of keep this all really relaxed here. Don't want to overdo it, I'm forming too much here. This is relaxed, that's beautiful. O to U to E, here we go, O. Wonderful, to E. Oh, I like that, I like that. Don't you like that? Now some of us do what we would normally do too, right? And we felt like that what sounded like an E to us. Let's go all the way to E. All the way to here. And we still feel that sense of that O space and that oo hootiness all coming into the E. Here we go. O. Beautiful. Thanks, Trevor, with the spinning still. Yes. To the hooty oo. And all the way to that E gently. All the way there. Oh, that's so nice. You've just woken up just about everything in your voice. Let's go one further though. At the very end, let's sing O again. Here we go. O. Now out here, O. That's the sound. That final O has all of these qualities in it. I love it. Let's just not stop there. How about this? Now it's bass time. O. So E to O. What I love what you didn't do, which I might remind to my chorus, is E. Taking that back where it started. No. Right out here. It feels like it's actually in front of your face. It's not even in you anymore. Right out here. Let's try that. Oh, here we go. Oh. Gently. Ooh. To E. Now slide down nice and slow and feel how it feels. I love it. Beautiful. And now here. Enjoy yourself. if I could do that, I'd never sing baritone again. It's only on Saturday at Harmony U. All right, I love it. Okay, we're going to, my friend Tony, my dear friend Tony, is going to teach you a song that has none of what we just did in the song, ever, right? So I just thought, he's got a lot of, hey, we're going to sing like this. And we didn't do any of that. So just to kind of help him out a little bit, let's do a little thing. I'd like to just play a little game with you. We're going to sing My Wild Irish Rose, but I'd like you all in your voice part to kind of play with this a little bit. Tenor singers, when you're in your upper notes in the song, feel like it's just got this light kind of bell-like quality. But as you get a little bit lower in your range on that song, feel like you're getting much more expressive and much more lead-like. Lead singers, the higher you are in your range, the more you want to have that tenor quality, and the lower you are in range, and it's just subtly. So you actually don't want to get caught doing this, right? Like someone could tell you did it, but that you subtly have a little bit more of that tenor quality up top, and as you get into the lower part of your range, it just has a little bit of that bassiness kicking in, just the littlest bit, right? And then in your mid range, you're just doing what you normally do. Baritones, you can already know where we're headed. I had about 900 of you in the class on Wednesday, and we had a great time together. But baritones, what we're going to do in the upper, our upper range, we're going to have a lot of that tenor quality. Lower range, just a little bit of that bassiness. And in the mid range, very expressive like the leads. And basses, as you come up on your notes, how lead-like can you be? How expressive can you be as you approach kind of the middle range in the song? My Wild Irish Rose, a B-flat. Not B-flat. We'll use, thank you. First chord, my. So where are you? Where are you? Okay, here we go. What's changing? Gorgeous, wow.
You may search
That was a total accident that worked like that. Thank you. Enjoy your day.